구하러 모이더래요.
There is no other woman that has a story like Suzanne O'Bear's in the history of New Zealand. No other European person, let alone a woman, went and did the things that Suzanne O'Bear did. Her unwavering dedication to the care and well-being of the Māori people in Hawke's Bay and everywhere that she went is unparalleled.
Not long after her arrival in Hawke's Bay, Suzanne O'Bear was involved in the mission to Māori throughout the wider area.
She travelled by buggy to Miani, and it was at Miani that she lived with Father Rainier, Father Michael, and Marist lay brothers.
She was pretty worn by this time with all the upheaval, and in Hawke's Bay, in Miani in particular, she was nurtured back to health with the French Marist priests. She cared for them, they had good community relationships.
The way that she approached our people earned respect immediately. She was welcomed. She demonstrated her humility and her worth through being a person of medicine and working with our people at a time when they were very ill and struck by Western illness.
She set up a dispensary. People would come to her dispensary, they'd sit on the grass and wait for her to dispense her medicine.
Suzanne came to know the local Māori chiefs and gained their trust. She regularly visited many pā in the area and became the mainstay of the Māori mission in Hawke's Bay.
The enduring legacy of Suzanne O'Bear comes in three forms in my mind. One is education and the introduction of European education through the Marist school at Miani. Many of our Ngāti Kahungunu leaders were taught by Suzanne O'Bear as a child. And the influence of her teaching in their formative years is prevalent throughout their careers. Secondly, as the first district nurse to Māori in Hawke's Bay, and the legacy of being the first European, let alone the first woman, to combine the traditional Māori practice of rongoā and herbal medicine with Western chemistry and science to create the medicines that she did. And then of course her final lasting legacy is the Church of the Immaculate Conception at Pakipaki and securing the Māori mission here in Hawke's Bay, which lives on through all of us and the descendants of those first Catholics.
Pilgrims can make a journey. We talk about going to France or Spain or Italy to make a pilgrimage, but look, you can do it in New Zealand. You can trace the footsteps of Suzanne all the way from Auckland through the Waikato down to Hawke's Bay, Hawke's Bay to the Whanganui River, Whanganui River to Wellington, Wellington down the west coast, and so forth and so on.
To put yourself in her footsteps in the sacred spaces of Suzanne O'Bear and where she was in Hawke's Bay is to understand that here was this young French nun in the prime of her life who was a teacher, who was a botanist and a chemist, who was a sister of mercy to those who had been disadvantaged by the establishment of the legal system here in Aotearoa, namely Ke Reo Pitirau, and spending the night with him before his execution. To understand just the breadth of knowledge and talent that this woman had, and the way that she gave freely of herself, you can only understand that by being there at that space and understanding the time of life that she had here in Hawke's Bay, which she describes as the happiest years of her life.